spiral down.
This bloke is unpredictable, Gus. You can't put that tag on him, mate. He's going to prove you wrong every time. He's incredible.
I tell you what, he's getting hurt, though, Frank. He's getting hurt. He's getting hurt, Frank.
He's
getting hurt.
Oh. Now that was a... He got hurt then.
Yeah, he's going to get hurt. That's it. Well, Frankie, that was quite an experience. We saw a world-class fighter do a world-class job with another world-class fighter. This is one of those events that we'll remember for a long time. The thing now is to get Omotosa the correct opponent to make his career go further. Frankie, this is Murray Thompson's 52nd show. Let's you and I look forward to the 53rd. A good night of boxing at Knock Basketball. Omotosa shows world class on the way to a world title. Knocks out Emmanuel Augustus with the ninth round. Good night, Frankie. All the best, pal.
Good night.
See you the next time.
See you, Mike.
The time. Round 9, 2 minutes, 40 seconds. While they come to center ring, referee Chris Anderson and Emmanuel Augustus. How about a big round of applause? One of the best fights you'll see in recent years, Murray Thompson promotion. The time, 2 minutes, 40 seconds into round 9, taking his record to 14 bouts, 14 wins, 12 inside the distance. The Big O, Awali Omotosa. And how about a big round of applause for the outlaw, E40, Emmanuel Augustus. Great sportsmanship there between the two men. Emmanuel, you've been all over the world. How do you rate Omotosa?
Omotosa is a head above everybody else. You know, next to him comes Mickey Ward. So, you know, Mickey Ward gave me one hell of a fight. They ended up being the fight of the year over in the States. And the only person to outdo him is my man right here. I mean, my man put it on me. I did the best I could. I trained hard for this fight, and the better man came out on top. And so, you know, I take my hat off to him, you know, and I clap until my hands fall off. He fought his heart out, and he deserved the win that he got.
Emmanuel, you've been boxing for 17 years as a professional. You reckon you'll fight till you're 40?
Oh, I don't know if I'll fight till I'm 40, but after this beating that I just got tonight, I mean, it wasn't that bad of a beating, but it was enough for me to lose, so, you know, I have to go back to the drawing board, get back in the gym, make sure that this is something that I want to continue doing. I'm getting up in age right now. I need to really start focusing on, you know, a plan B. I can't box all my life, so, you know, I box enough of my life as it is, so I'm getting up in the stone age, so to speak, so now I need to start coming up with something else to do. But my man right here, you know, all props go to him. I take my hat off to him, man a box.
What a gracious sportsman, Emmanuel Augustus.
The king is dead. Long live the king.
Long live the king. What a great sportsman, Emmanuel Augustus, from Chicago via Baton Rouge, Louisiana, via Concord. How about three cheers for Awali? Hip hip, hooray! Hip hip! Hey! Hip hip! Awali was right up there. Big test tonight, wasn't it?
Yeah, the big test.
And first of all, I'm going to thank God for the victory. And secondly, I'm going to thank my trainer, my trainer, my manager, my sponsor, Maureen Thompson. I thank you so much. I know this is the beginning. It's a big test, and I'm very happy for it because it makes me have more experience to the case I go to overseas to go and fall. And again, I thank everyone for your support. Thanks, everyone. I love everyone. And this is the beginning. The way I always said it, I said I'm looking forward to be a world champion. And I know by the grace of God and by the support of everyone from the gym and my trainer, Maureen Thompson, I know we're going to get there by the mighty grace of God. I can't wait to be a world champion. Thanks, everyone.
Keep punching. Murray, come into the ring and just say a couple of words. Murray, gracious words from Emmanuel Augustus. It was a great fight, one of your best ever main events.
Yeah, well, I reckon it was one of the best main events ever. I mean, the biggest name. And it's an honour to have these sort of people on the show. These guys have fought the best in the world. And to have someone, you know, beat them and beat them convincingly, it's unreal. And we've got some we can go with here in Wali. And we just see how far we go. And I just thank everyone here for supporting us, because we need your support. Because to get to the top, it just takes a lot of money. And we need to fight guys like this to gain the experience. We've been offered fights in Mexico, but it's like against guys who have fought like, you know, 10 or 15 guys like Augustus. And we need to fight 10 or 15 Emmanuel Augustus's or people like him to so he can go, you know, 8, 9, 10 rounds and still knock them out. I want to thank everyone. We do this every year. We remember Mick Canavan, my trainer, and many other people in this room who he touched. And what you see here tonight is basically everything I've learned from Mick. Mick taught me everything in life and boxing.
Thank you, Murray. Okay, give a Wally a big round of applause. He left center ring. A big winner here tonight. Thank you for staying behind. Yes, Elio? What's that? All the auction items are up the back there. On behalf of Murray Thompson, Finest Factory Promotions, the Mick Canavan 10th Annual Fight Night, we say protect yourself at all times, both physically and emotionally. Reach for the stars. May God bless. Peace on earth. We are one nation. You got to fight for your right to party. And keep punching. Good night from Fort Knox. Thank our commentators. Gus Mercurio, former Australian welterweight champion, Frank Ropers. Keep punching in the main event. Australia's Aussie boy, Awali Amatoso, beat the legendary American, Emmanuel Outlaw E40 Augustus, with a big stoppage. A big night of boxing concludes at Fort Knox, Fentry Gully, Victoria, Australia. Good night, night, night.